Chris Forsberg, and I'm a Formula Drift champion. Well, this gold 280Z is one of my favorite cars I have. It's actually my street car, but it is not the easiest car to drive, and we wanted to do a couple upgrades to make it that much more fun on the streets. We have a huge mess of parts going into this car, not only suspension related, but also drivetrain and better brakes. Beyond installing all these parts, we brought in Jason from Engineering Explained to help break down exactly what it takes to set up a proper drift car. Now see, where this car would work just fine going in a straight line, when you're cutting through the corners, you really want to have specific alignments to get all the grip in the front rear that you can. And this chassis actually has zero adjustments in the rear and very limited adjustments in the front. So now we're going to be able to set up our camber, caster, and toe so that we can dial this car in for the perfect feel. First part of the front end is this control arm from Techno Toy Tuning. This has adjustable track width, which allows you to extend this lower control arm to reduce your scrub radius.
So Forsberg has increased the length of his control arms, and in doing so, he's increased the track width. Proportionally, we're doing the same thing as lowering the center of gravity. So the load transfer is going to be less to that outside tire, and you'll have more grip. Now, by pushing out the wheels, you also allow for the wheels to turn more, so you can have more steering angle, and this allows for greater slip angles.
Next up is the caster arm, also known as a tension rod. This is what keeps your wheel from moving back and forth and allows you to dial in your caster.
Caster is the angle of the steering axis when you're looking at the car from the side. So if we have our caster angle like that, that's going to be referred to as positive caster. So if you're looking down on this, it's going to look like your steering axis is up here and your contact patch of the tire is down here. So as you rotate that wheel, the contact patch is going to come out here. So as the tire is out this direction, it's going to want to force it back to straight ahead. So it's going to give you good steering feedback, good steering feel, and it's going to build progressively as you turn into it. And then as you let go of the wheel, it's going to return it back to straight ahead.
Our next piece is a new outer tie rod end with this adjustable height pickup point. This allows us to correct the bump steer with a lowered vehicle. Bump steer is the effect when you go over a bump in the road with the wheels turned and the wheel actually continues to adjust because the tie rod pickup and the lower control arm are not on the same plane. So your toe is physically changing as you go through compression.
Toe is the angle of the tires looking down on the car from above. So if you look down on the front axle and the tires are pointed like this, this is referred to as toe out. If those tires point in, that's referred to as toe in. In drifting, you're gonna wanna have a slight amount of toe out, and this helps with turn in so that as you turn the wheel, the car reacts very quickly.
Now the front suspension of a drift car is typically pretty soft because you want the spring to be able to adjust those bumps, but you need a really good shock to handle a soft spring so that when you do go over those bumps, you don't get a really porpoisey effect and have the car go bouncing down the road. Our next new shiny part for the front end is this billet hub from Techno Toy to match up with a Wilwood vented rotor. These old cars obviously have very outdated brakes, and when you're adding this much power and grip, you wanna make sure you can stop too. To finish off the front end, we have our T3 camber plates installed up top. These will allow us to fine tune the camber of the front end by adding negative camber, which will keep that tire planted flat as we increase our steering angle.
Camber is the angle of the tires when looking at the car from behind. So if the bottom of the tire is further out than the top of the tire, this is referred to as negative camber. Now in drifting, you want pretty aggressive negative camber, and this is because as you're cornering, you're gonna have that force and it's going to cause the tire to rotate onto its contact patch. So as you're in a pretty heavy corner, that contact patch is gonna be maximized and roll onto itself so you can maximize grip going through the corner.
To finish it off, we have a new set of Hankook RS3 tires matched up with our SSR MS1 wheels. We went with a 16x9 wheel in the front to give us a little more clearance for this extra steering angle. All right, well, that was fun. Thanks for watching, and thank you to Jason for coming out and helping out.
Yeah, this has been awesome. Thanks for having me, and I hope you guys learned something.
If you want to see more videos, make sure to click around, and don't forget to subscribe.